So how do you solve math sequences? I'm Jimmy, and I'm here to give you a little glimpse as to what couple of sequences that are out there and how you go about doing that. The important thing to look at is pattern. And as long as you see what kind of pattern are in the first few numbers of the sequence that they're going to give you, you should be good to go. Now, let's talk about two basic kinds of sequences. The first kind of sequence is what's called an arithmetic sequence. Now, an arithmetic sequence is one in where you can figure out what the terms of the sequence are by adding or subtracting by the exact same number throughout. And here's a basic example of this. Suppose you have 1, 4, 7, 10, and 13. Now, after a while, you can figure out easily what number did I have to add or subtract between each number to figure out what the terms are. Obviously, 1 plus 3 is 4, 4 plus 3 is 7, 7 plus 3 is 10, and so after a while, you'll get the idea that the pattern is adding by 3. Well, that lets you figure out what the next terms are. From 13, I know to add 3, that is going to give me 16. And then from 16, I can add 3 again to give me 19, and of course, the sequence would continue. The other kind of sequence is a geometric sequence. It's one in which you can figure out the terms by multiplying or dividing by the same number. Take a look at these numbers down here. 2, negative 4, 8, negative 16, 32. Well, it's pretty easy for you to figure out that 2 times what number is going to give me negative 4? It has to be negative 2. The pattern continues. So what you want to do is start from 32, multiply by negative 2 to get negative 64, and then take negative 64 and multiply that by negative 2, and you get positive 128. So, I hope this helps a little bit in terms of understanding sequences. I'm Jimmy, and that's how you simplify some math sequences.